quick look at the flash business headlines. From overseas, a big beat. Streaming giant Netflix added 9.33 million customers in the first quarter of this year, posting its best start to the year since 2020 as it attracted new customers, particularly in the U.S. and Canada, helped in part by the crackdown on password sharing. Despite the growth, though, Netflix shares still fell nearly 5% to just $582.7 following unimpressive forecasts for the quarter and the announcement that it will stop reporting quarterly subscribers by next year. And a Florida jury on Thursday concluded that Johnson & Johnson's baby powder talc product did not cause the ovarian cancer of a Florida woman who died in 2019. The lawsuit was brought by family members of Patricia Maffei, a Sarasota County resident who used Johnson's baby powder daily from 1965 until August 2016, when she was diagnosed with ovarian cancer. Meanwhile, Tesla shares fell to their lowest in more than a year on Thursday after Deutsche Bank raised concerns over the EV maker's increasing focus on its autonomous vehicle products when profit is under pressure. The Elon Musk-led company shares fell 2.7% to $151.26 after the brokerage downgraded the stock to hold and cut its price target to $123 from $189. Seattle-based retail giant Nordstrom says the founding family behind the department store chain has shown an interest in pursuing a potential go-private deal, prompting the company's board to form a special committee of independent directors to evaluate any proposal. The move comes at a time when department store chains across the U.S. are grappling with weak sales, a sticky inflation, and elevated borrowing costs have led customers to rethink their discretionary spending. And finally, the International Monetary Fund cautions Asian central banks against prioritizing what they think the U.S. Federal Reserve will do and following that as they lay out their own policy paths. Instead, the IMF says Asian central banks should focus on their own domestic inflation and avoid making their policy decisions overly dependent on anticipated moves by other central banks, warning doing the latter could undermine price stability in their own countries. As the Philippine Business for Education, or PBED, vows to improve the employability of young Filipinos, especially amid the threat of digitalization on jobs. Citing a study by the International Labor Organization, PBED says about 18 million Filipinos are at risk of losing their jobs to automation. One of the ways the group plans to address this is through its Jobs Next program, which aims to future-proof young entrants to the workforce by digitally upskilling them.
Is really to prepare our young entrants to the workforce, the Filipino youth, onto the jobs, or the training them for the jobs of tomorrow. So when we say jobs of tomorrow, it would include digital skills, like, for example, the basic data analytics, data presentations, and then it could even go onto specifics like cybersecurity, cloud computing. When we train the youth for this certain jobs, or for the certain skills, there are jobs waiting for them.
Right.
So technically, it's making sure that we address the skills gap. We expose our, let's say, senior high school students that there are job opportunities in this area or in this sector. It would, let's say, encourage them to build up a career in this, in the sector.
Here's the era of the Tortured Poets Department has finally arrived. In just a few hours, global pop superstar Taylor Swift will be dropping her new album, and Fortnite, featuring Post Malone, has been chosen by the chairwoman of the department as its first single. Taylor's 11th album will feature 16 tracks and 4 bonus songs. The lead-up to the release day has been littered with puzzles and Easter eggs, much to the delight of her dedicated and sleuthing fan base.